Welcome back to my channel. This tutorial have two parts. In one part, we will learn how to model a power bank and assemble the electronic components into the power bank. And in second part of this tutorial, we will learn how to add decals and appearances and how to render photorealistic pictures in Solidworks. So without wasting any time, let's start this. First of all, select front plane and left click sketch button from command manager. Select center point straight slot tool and draw a horizontal slot. Select smart dimension tool and set dimension of this line to 75 and the width as 18. Exit the sketch. Now select the sketch and go to feature menu and select extruded boss. Set the extrude length to 28 and hit OK. Now select this surface and go to sketch in command manager. Select offset entities tool. Select the offset value as 1 mm. Take the reverse button and hit OK. Exit the sketch. Select the sketch and go to features menu and select extruded cut. Set the value of cut to 2 mm. Now select this face of the body and go to sketch menu. Right click on the sketch and hit normal to the plane button. Select offset entities tool and click on this face. Set the offset value as 0.5 mm and hit OK. Exit the sketch. Select the sketch from design tree and go to features menu and select extruded boss. Set the value as 1 mm and hit OK. Now select this face and start a new sketch. Right click on the sketch and hit normal to the plane. Select offset entities tool and click on this face. Set the offset value as 0.5 and check the reverse button. Now go to features menu and hit extruded boss. Set the value of extrude length as 145 mm and hit OK. Now select this face and start a new sketch. Select offset entities tool and click on this face. Set the offset value as 1 mm and hit OK. Exit the sketch. Select the sketch and hit the extruded cut from features menu. Set the cut depth as 0.5 mm. Now we will make cutouts for connectors and LEDs to fit in. Select this face and start a new sketch. Select center point rectangle tool and draw a rectangle with width of 15.5. and height of 15. Set the distance between center point and the origin as 27. Hold Ctrl key and select midpoint and the origin and hit horizontal relation. edit the sketch. Now go to Features menu and select Extruded Cut and set the depth of cut as 8mm. Hit OK. Select face and start a sketch. Right click on sketch and hit normal to the plane. Select rectangle tool and draw two rectangles like this. Select smart dimension tool and set the size as 8. And this size as 2. Select these two lines and hit equal. Select these two lines and hit equal. Set this dimension as 13.1 and this as 5.72. Hold Ctrl key and select the origin and the midpoint of the rectangles. Set them horizontal. Now exit the sketch. Now select the sketch and apply Extruded Cut feature. Set the cut length as 15mm and hit OK. Again select this face and hit the Extruded Cut feature. Select the center point rectangle tool and draw the rectangle. Hold Ctrl key and select midpoint and the origin and set them horizontal. Set this dimension as 8.94 and this as 3.16. Set the distance between origin and midpoint rectangle as 30. Now select the sketch fillet tool and set the value of fillet to 1.3 mm and start selecting the corners of rectangle. Exit the sketch. Set the cut length as 8mm and hit OK. So far we have created the main body of the power bank. Now we will assemble the connectors and 7 segment 2 digit LED panel. I have downloaded 3D models of these components from traceparts.com. I will share the links in the description below. Now save the component and name it whatever you want. Go to File and create a new assembly. Select the power bank body. Insert it in the graphic area. Now go to Assembly feature and hit Insert Component. Now click Browse and go to the folder where you have already placed the 3D files of the components. Select the files and open. Now drag the models and place them in graphic area one by one. Now select Mate command and start mating coincident mates on the face of the components and main body. select this face of the USB type A socket and mate it with this face of the body and hit reverse. Drag the component out and select the top surface and mate it with the top surface of the cavity. Select the front surface and mate it with front surface of the body. Now select the top surface of the Type-C USB socket and mate it with top surface of the cavity. Now select the rotate component command and click on this component and rotate it like this. Now go to mate command and mate this edge and this face together. Mate the front face of the socket and mate body like this. Left click this connector and press Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V to make a copy of the component. Select the mate command and mate the faces like this. Our tutorial for creating a power bank is now completed. We have learned basic part modeling and assembly features in this tutorial. If you want to learn how to add decals and colors as shown in the picture and how to render photorealistic pictures, click on this pop-up link as shown above and check out the second part of this tutorial.